The European Committee of the Region is a political assembly. It is an advisory body for the other European institutions. It promotes the principle of subsidiarity, which means that decisions must be taken at the level of government that best serves the public interest. The European Committee of the Region stands for a common interest of all regions and cities in the decision-making process. The European Committee of the Region works to bring the EU citizens closer to the EU by involving regional and local representatives who are in daily contact with the electorates concerned. The committee contributes to reducing the gap between the EU institutions and the citizens of the European Union. And this cannot be any further from the truth than in these days and age. Take one look at the committee's COVID-19 platform. One sees the action being taken at the local and regional levels to fight this virus which has disturbed so many of our lives. The European Committee of the Region is represented by its 329 politicians who come from the local and regional level of all 27 member states. The politicians of the European Committee of the Regions are supported by a secretariat composed of 500 people working from its headquarters in Brussels. Like the Parliament, our members come from different member states and belong to the 6 political groups. Only a few of them are not belonging to any political group. The number of our politicians per country is linked with population. Big countries like Italy have 24 members. A small country like Malta has only 5 members. Our members are local and regional politicians. They are selected on the basis of national law but formally appointed by the Council of the European Union. They have a mandate of 5 years which can be renewed. But the mandate comes to an end if a member loses his or her political role at home, a mayor who has lost the election for the town hall, or who becomes a politician in the national government, cannot continue as a member in the European Committee of the Regions. Like in the Parliament, we have different thematic commissions dealing with the European law. In the European Committee of the Regions, we have currently 6 thematic commissions. NAT Commission, for instance, stands for Natural Resources. All opinions concerning natural resources, like water for instance, are prepared in that commission before the final vote takes place in the plenary. And finally, like in the European Parliament, the President and First Vice President come from the largest groups, serving 2.5 years each. Mr. Apostolos Tsitsikostas is currently president and Mr. Vasco Alves Cordeiro is first vice president. So if everything seems like the European Parliament, why is there a need for the European Committee of the Regions? Simple answer is, because we are the closest to the European citizens. Our political members spend most of their time in their regions and in their cities. They only come to the European Committee of the Regions for the work in the thematic commissions and the plenaries. Their job at the European Committee of the Region is a complementary work to their full-time job as a mayor, a city councillor, or a president of a region. Furthermore, our members don't get a salary for their activity in our committee, but they get a daily allowance for the time being in Brussels and a reimbursement for the travel expenses. So you realize, good advice does not have to be expensive. So while the Parliament has in mind the interest of the citizens, the Council has in mind the interest of the member states, and the Commission has in mind the general interest of the European Union. But the European Committee of the Regions stands for the local and regional authorities and their interest in Brussels.